time up.
Obviously, because I'm divided on it. Because on the one hand, especially if you're doing something like photography, you should stand and fall on your work. You know, I think it's perfectly justifiable wanting to impress people somehow with your personality. Why not? I mean, fuck me, you turn on the telly all day and you get Terry Wogan and all that stuff. Why shouldn't you sell something a bit more interesting to people?
Personal stuff is good.
Yeah,
I like that. It's good just to wander around and see what he's doing. I mean, I've seen some of the adverts, but I find it more interesting seeing his personal work, find out what he's interested in. I mean, I was talking to Iain just now, and he's thinking of actually having people working over there.
Yeah, that's good. Hold it there.
Okay, a little bit more, Nick. Just a little bit more. That's it. That's enough.
I quite like the idea of that. I'm going to come down next week for a couple of hours and see him working, and then I can get to know him and see what he's actually doing.
Sure. I'd love to come along and have my picture taken.
Have you yet?
No, I haven't.
No, well.
One of my trouble just for a minute. I'm a photographer and I'm having an exhibition at my studio next week. And I want to know if it'd be possible, if you're interested in coming down to the show and me taking a portrait of you. The idea is it's going to be a photograph of you, which will be for a follow-up exhibition about a year later. And, would you be interested in that?
Sounds interesting, yeah.
Liked his work, so it's really good to suddenly come here, and especially to do our picture, which will appear in the magazine. We suddenly thought it'd be a really good idea to take the atmosphere of his show and to put it into our magazine.
Yeah, I think it's quite nice to see them walking things. Yeah. Let's say she looks at her feet because she's watching her mark, I think. Mm. You know what I mean?
Great, well, pass the message on.
Right,
you.
1, 2, 3, off you go.
Of course, I'd love you to come here. It's really
okay,
great. It's really fun.
Good.
I mean,
okay,
do you know about it? I've said
a little bit more lively.
Basically, he's just opened up this whole studio. He's done something.
It's good fun. I want all you lot, everyone in with SVC to come down. It's just good luck. And down for a drink sometime this week.
Right, that's good.
But he's here all the time taking portraits, obviously. It's really interesting for
them. The girls are pretending to be looking around the show, and the clothes are quite unusual. We're taking bits and pieces that wouldn't usually go together, things like diamante earrings with sportswear, things that you wouldn't usually put together, and then photographing them amongst his pictures.
Just 17 magazine, little student here, just sort of standing around.
It's interesting to see somebody showing different mediums
to work with. I mean, his pictures are taken on various formats, using various films, which is, you know, the key to photography, really. I mean, you've got to keep it changing things. I mean, it's all right when you get to know how to use one brand of lighting and one set of film, but it's far more fun to experiment. I mean, Polaroid is something, an interest in which I share with him very greatly. I think Polaroid's a wonderful film. It's nice to see that he's got a different range of subjects from Gambia to his work for record companies and magazines. I think he's changed quite a lot over the 5 years, from what he used to do to what he's doing now. I mean, it's a retrospective exhibition as well as an up-to-date. I mean, it gets rid of the preciousness of galleries. I mean, I've shown at the Photographer's Gallery, and it's a great place, but they don't, you know, it's so sort of like traditional. You can't put pictures on the floor there, they don't like that. I tried. They said, put them on the walls like everybody else. I thought it'd be better to put them on the floor and put a Polaroid on the wall. You stare at a small picture and then look down at a big picture at your feet. But it's nice to see a photographer working. I don't know how many jobs I could do with 25 people watching. I've done them with people watching it. Every time you turn around, you see a different set of eyes, you know.
Where you were looking. Okay, hold it there now. Okay. One more for insurance.
I think photography is very much, you know, two against one. Hopefully with the photographer winning.
So it's black, light tone, and then dark behind. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So like, you just sort of jump out more.
Yeah.
The stars. But while we're waiting to get the backdrop to go, I'm going to take something else so I think about it. So.
Yeah. I know what he means.
Taking
the photos, he's very relaxing person to work with.
Excuse me, quite interested in maybe taking a photograph with you. The idea I've got actually is doing something on the roof, which I haven't really done yet. So if you're not in a hurry, is that alright, yeah? Okay, alright, follow me then. So you work at the palace?
Yeah, I do.
What do you do there?
Oh,
right. Well, what I'm doing is I'm sort of documenting the exhibition by taking portraits of people that come to the show, you know, whether it's, you know, businessmen who work in the city.
What I was going to say was not even knowing anything about photographs at all, and you know, the first time I've ever been to an exhibition like this, it's a real eye-opener. You can see that the way the pictures are presented and, you know, the style of his work. I've learnt a lot just walking around in 10 minutes in this place, you know. And you sort of, you don't just look at a picture, you look at the lighting, the depth, the positioning of things, and, you know, it's really interesting.
Well, I didn't really come here to see the exhibition, but I came here to see a photographer working.
Yeah, well, but see, what I do is I teach people how to cut hair, and part of that is doing photographic sessions, and obviously it's quite an integral part of my job, so that's why I'm here to take a class round to show them the exhibition.
stick to what you want to do, she's not going to be happy.
I know she's been here quite a lot to see. Seen quite a few pop stars. Was that what you imagined it was going to be like, meeting people like Captain Sensible?
No.
I didn't think we'd meet anyone. Not talk to anyone, but we did.
They were really friendly as well. You'd think they'd just come here, have the photos taken and go, but they talk to you and everything.
Hello.
Hi.
Has anyone got a bigger nose than I've got? No?
No, I can touch my nose with my tongue though.
Can you? Oh, shall I say it? When do the pubs open? And cross fold your arms as well. Like that. Because I'll show you the photo of it. Come on. It's nice.
Place where a lot of different artistic people were gathering together, and the exchange on that level was massive. People could watch each other, study each other's styles, words, different things like that, and I found that it was a great place for people to pick up comedy ideas, photographic ideas, painting ideas. A lot of different things were happening all at once and very quickly, and for the people who were aware of that. It was a great place for them to be at that time.
I want to do it on voiceover because there's so many images which have come out of the show. I mean, he's taken over 90 portraits and we've got to show them. It's really important. I mean, that's the whole thing about the show. And that's what I want to sell. And I want to get the humour of it across and all the whole feel of it.